This video is sponsored by Skillshare. If you go to skl.sh/polyphonic19, you can get 2 months of Skillshare absolutely free. When you break music down to its basest core, what do you get? Well, on the lowest level, you get vibrations creating sound. But sound alone isn't music. There might be a few ways you can turn sound into music, but the easiest is recursion. When a pattern of sounds repeats a few times, the human brain turns it into a rhythm and finds music in it. And the levels of recursion build from there. Music builds recurring themes into rhythms, and then builds recurring rhythms into song structure. In popular music, songs are most often built around repetitions of melodic patterns that become verses and choruses. Music is all about repeating patterns. Anyways, this video is about Michel Gondry. Let's take a closer look. Michel Gondry might be the most iconic music video director working today. He's particularly known for his work with the White Stripes, the Chemical Brothers, and Bjork, but his filmography has seen him collaborate with everyone from Daft Punk to Donald Fagen. Across his career, many of his signatures have become evident: mixed media, camera tricks, stop motion, and surreal comedy, to name a few. But what interests me most about Gondry is the way he uses recursion. What interests me most about Gondry is the way he repeats things. You see, the thing with repetition is that each time you repeat something, a musical phrase, a lyrical melody, a film shot, it gains new meaning. That's part of the reason why people listen to music or watch movies over and over again. There's a beauty in coming back to something familiar, but each time you come back to something you already know, you come at it with new eyes, new ears. You create your own growth through repetition. Within Gondry's work, you can see this growth play out in real time as you notice new details in each passing repetition. In this sense, repetition allows videos to grow. The best example of this from Gondry's work may be Kylie Minogue's Come Into My World. Upon first glance, Come Into My World might appear to be a pretty typical music video. The song opens on a chorus and we see Kylie walking through a street as the chaotic happenings of the city take place behind her. But when we reach the chorus, things start to reveal themselves. We realize that Kylie is walking in an extended loop, and as she reaches the door, a new version of Kylie steps out, starting her journey just as the first did, at the beginning of the chorus. These stories stack on top of each other as the song continues. Each subsequent chorus brings with it a new iteration of Kylie Minogue and the city behind her. All these iterations are overlaid, creating an increasingly chaotic scene, and making you more and more aware of the intricate dance that is urban life. Many of Gondry's videos start out seemingly normal, but grow meaning as they go on. And this is representative of music, in a sense. As a song progresses through repetitions of verses and choruses, its meaning grows to the listener, and you become aware of the small variations therein. The best example of this from Gondry's work may be the Chemical Brothers' Star Guitar. Upon first glance, Star Guitar may appear to be a pretty typical music video. We open on a shot of a passing landscape outside of a train window. But the repetitions quickly become evident. Water towers start to pass at regular intervals, then a pattern of smokestacks emerge. It quickly becomes clear that these aren't just repetitions for repetition's sake. They're the Chemical Brothers' music represented visually. Each of the repeating elements of the song is represented in the passing landscape. The recursion here makes the listener aware of the recursive patterns in music, particularly poignant given the makeup of the Chemical Brothers' electronica music. Gondry uses repetition to create visual patterns that mimic the patterns within the accompanying music. The best example of this from Gondry's work may be Daft Punk's Around the World. In that video, each piece of the song is represented by a team of dancers dressed in the same clothing. As the bassline climbs up, we see dancers walk upstairs, and when it runs down, we see them run back down. When Daft Punk's robotic vocal line comes in, we get a series of marching robots. This is a literal representation of the music as they walk around in a circle. Repetition and recursion are key themes of Around the World. The whole song builds around a repetitive phrase that itself conjures the idea of repetition, going around the world over and over forever. Thanks to the choreography of Gondry's dancers, we're able to appreciate the nuances within Daft Punk's music and the growth of the song on a foundation of repetition. And while electronica lends itself particularly well to explorations of recursion, the concept can also play out in rock music. The best example of this from Gondry's rock work is probably The Hardest Button to Button by the White Stripes. That video has a simple concept, illustrating the musical notes with physical depictions of instruments. By repeating the instrument for each note, Gondry creates a kind of visual sheet music. You can appreciate how the guitar and drums come together to create a song. One of the key aspects of the White Stripes was minimalism, something that plays into repetition as well. Minimalism asks what happens when you strip something down to its most base form. And when you break music down to its basest core, what do you get? Well, on the lowest level, you get vibrations creating sound, but sound alone isn't music. There might be a few ways you can turn sound into music, but the easiest is recursion. When a pattern of sounds repeats a few times, the human brain turns it into a rhythm and finds music in it. And the levels of recursion build from there. Music builds recurring themes into rhythms, then builds recurring rhythms into song structure. In popular music, songs are most often built around repetitions of melodic patterns that become verses and choruses. Music is all about repeating patterns. Anyways, this video is about Michel Gondry. Michel Gondry has a big budget for his experimentation now, but he started out as an indie filmmaker, and his early work proves that you don't need a big budget to make dynamic, interesting, or experimental films. If you want to try out some filmmaking yourself, you should check out Matty Brown's low-budget filmmaking on Skillshare. That course will teach you a DIY approach to filmmaking that can help you shoot your own music videos, short films, or even just small personal pieces. And if you go over to skl.sh/polyphonic19, you can try that course out completely free. But that's not all. On a 2-month trial, you'll have access to all of Skillshare's 25,000 plus topics. That means you can check out Paula Scherer's course on logo design and learn to create your own system of branding. And really, that's just the beginning. You could learn to step up your coffee game, make the perfect grilled cheese, or create a new system for your productivity. If you follow the link in the description, you'll get 2 months for free. Not only will you be able to learn something new, but following that link is a big help to me because it shows Skillshare that I sent you. So go ahead and try something new.